Welcome to the Core Interaction System plugin overview. This plugin is designed to help you create interactions in Unreal Engine using a simple component-based setup. Here's the best part. This plugin is completely free and always will be. When setting up any interaction in the Core Interaction System, there are two key components that have a logic, the Receiver Component and the Trigger Component. Any actor that needs to be interacted with requires a receiver component. This component is where you define actions, essentially the functions that will be executed when the interaction occurs. For example, you could set up an action to open a door, toggle a light, or play an animation. These actions will be called whenever the actor is triggered. On the other side, an actor that initiates interaction needs a trigger component. This component is responsible for activating one or more interactions by calling the activate interactions function. The activate interactions functions can be triggered by specific events such as overlaps, collisions, or even depth of an enemy. It's up to you. This makes the trigger component highly adaptable for various gameplay scenarios. To help you get you started, the plugin includes three pre-configured actors that automatically trigger events: the box trigger, which activates on overlaps, the hit trigger for collision-based interactions, and the rhythm trigger, designed for timing-based events. I want to show you an example of how to set up an interaction with a box trigger, a gate, point client, and a BP skeletal mesh. So as you can see, I have a box trigger here, and that's the only thing I need right now. Then we have a gate, which has three actions from receiver component, and the first one is toggling the gate. Then we check the point light, and as we can see, there's just one action that says the intensity of the light to the maximum. And then we see a BP skeletal mesh actor that stops the animation on begin play, but then on activate action one, it plays the animation. There is the action, there is the receiver component, and here is the action event. Now the only thing we need to do is to click on the box trigger, click on the begin overlap interactions trigger component, and we'll just add all the actors here. What we can also do is that we can group these three actors together. Check out the group actor 3 name in the outliner, and then add it here and add the group to configuration. Now when we have that, we just decide which action we want to activate when this triggers, and this is it. And we just try to, and as you can see, every single of these three actors is interacted. Before we finish, I want to highlight one additional feature included in the plugin, the shaking component. This component lets you modify an actor's transform, position, rotation, or scale using curves. It's perfect for effects like floating objects, green shakes, or recoil. Setup is simple. Add the component, define a curve, and specify the transform properties to adjust. You can also choose whether the effect plays once for quick actions, like shakes or recoils, or loops continuously for effects like floating animations. Thanks for watching. If you're interested in learning more, visit our website to explore all our plugins and tools for Unreal Engine. You'll also find more videos on our channel with overviews and tutorials for each plugin. Be sure to check them out to see what works best for your projects. If you enjoyed this, consider subscribing to stay updated on our latest tools and tutorials. We'd love to have you join us for more. See you in the next video.